The solar wind, when it arrives at the Earth, we know that the Earth has intrinsic magnetic field. This magnetic field gets distorted. Okay, so you basically form. Here is the Earth magnetic field. So you form this region ahead of the solar wind is coming from left to right. So magnetic, the solar wind pushes against the magnetic field of the Earth and forms this lobe ahead of the Earth. And then on the night side, you will have magnetic field will stretch out. It's very difficult to see what's going on. But the magnetic field of the Earth on the night side will form a very long elongated tail. So what's important about the magnetic field is it protects us. It deflects 90-70% of the solar wind and all particles that are coming from the sun. Only 3% of them, the highest energy particles, can penetrate through this magnetic field, and they can get trapped inside of this region. And when they get trapped, they will be bound to move along the closed field lines of the magnetic field. They will basically come to this region near the poles where the magnetic field gets concentrated. They'll get reflected due to magnetic mirroring, then they'll go to the other pole, they'll get reflected again, so they'll constantly bounce back and forth between the two poles. And some of the particles you will get entrapped into this donut-shaped region that goes out of the plate here, that's what it's called, radiation belt. And this radiation belt can be, as I said, produces excessive radiation when you send astronauts on the way to the moon and other regions, because they have to cross this radiation belt. They cross it for a very brief period of time, but still it can accumulate lots of doses of radiation during the passage of this radiation belt. As I said, 3% of the particles coming from the sun can penetrate to the magnetic field. Some of them will be concentrated, they will funnel down the poles. Okay. And then they will enter the atmosphere, and when they enter the atmosphere, what you have is beautiful auroras. It's like you have electric current passing through some gas, so the gas gets excited, and you have some beautiful emission. You have emission due to the hydrogen, oxygen, depending on which gas is excited, you have different colors. And you see auroras mostly from high latitudes. We all know that. However, sometimes when you have a powerful ejection coming from the sun, then you have a larger flux of high energy particles that can penetrate deep into the magnetosphere. And when they do that, when they penetrate deep into the magnetic field, then these field lines will map back to the Earth at the lower latitudes. Okay? And when they steam down the atmosphere, you see auroras from lower and lower latitudes. So when you see auroras from lower latitudes, say mid-latitudes, that's bad news. It's pretty, it's a big event for the local people, but that's bad news. This means that there is something really bad coming from the sun that you have to be aware of. And if you see aurora from Hawaii...